Welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. Cider spectacles. Got another one, the Aspall chaps here. Suffolk cider. This one's draft Suffolk spider. Suffolk cider. What are we talking? ABV 5.5. Ideally suited for accompanying meals. Or accompanying meals. Don't tell you what salt. Just accompanying food. Accompanying meals. Don't matter. Well, so, you know, I might be having licorice. Or I'm having licorice all sorts for dinner. A pot noodle. You know. A hot curry. And you, oh, makes me sick there. Or as a refreshing drink on its own. So you can either have it. What they suggest you do is either have it with a meal. Or have it on its own. Don't do anything otherwise with it. It just it says on here. You know, it's... it's ideally suited for accompanying meals or as a refreshing drink on its own. So don't use it for any... Right, in the comments below, if you can think of any other... the more imaginative, the better, right? But if you can think of any other purposes for having a cider, apart from either drinking with a meal or drinking without a meal, right, be great. Cleaning your windows, right, I've already had that one. I've owned up for that one. Putting on your face, is that cider vinegar, isn't it? Doing things like that. But anyway, I'm having that one as well. So it's up to you. You think of some. I bet you can't. Right, this should be fun. And now I've said that, like, I bet it's going to be a glorious cider. Because they do nice ciders. Anyway, enough of that. We've gone, how long? About 20 minutes into the video. Look, I've kind of got to the point in my life where I'm thinking that everyone's doing shorter and shorter videos. And they're like, you're getting there. I've actually got a little channel myself that's 30-second reviews, you know. And I've stopped adding to it because I can't get them in 30 seconds. I start getting passionate about either beers or ciders or whiskies or whatever I'm wines or whatever I'm doing. And I kind of find it hard to shut up. And I do apologise for that, but that's just how I am, you know. Right. That is the little chap with the three feathers. If anyone knows what that's all about, let me know. He's got his... His big bent old thing in his hand, his sword. So that's all good. So let's pour it out and see what we get. Aspall's. It's looking very light. Looking very, very light. I'll stop fizzing there. Just put it up to the camera microphone. I stopped doing it. Anyway, very, very light. Mildly carbonated from what it looks like. Looks like they've added CO2 to it. I was just... you know, that sort of thing. That's all good. See, I often think that kind of bottle conditioning and things in beers I'm talking about, or the natural carbonation, that I, you know, quite often I prefer that because it's less of an attack, it's less acidy sort of taste on the tongue, like that carbonic sort of acid taste. But every now and again, it's a nice thing when you get those carbonated beers. I don't want to do away with them or ciders or whatever, carbonated flavours, because sometimes they slake and scratch away at all the gum in your mouth. And sometimes it kind of does that to the tongue. Gets its claws out a little bit. Right, so twirl it up. A little bit of the old sulfites there I'm smelling. A little bit, maybe got a bit heavy-handed with the sulfites. It's not as bad as the, it's not as bad kind of sulfur smells as the vintage one that I tasted a little while ago. That was glorious, but to get that close to it was like someone farting in your face. Henry Weston's vintage, I think it was. And don't get me wrong, it was one of the, it was probably one of the best ciders I've ever had. But it was poor, all right, mate, get away. Like David farting in my face, you know, on that video, that thank you one that he did. Have a look on his thing, you'll see what I mean. Just look up Tuvar Thanks, and you'll see it come up, little blue screen thing. Gradually that farty smell is going away. Oh no, every time you twirl it round, it comes up again. So they've got a bit heavy-handed with the sulfites in there, I think. Yeah. It's putting me off of the other smells. Every time I smell it, it smells like a chemistry experiment. But it's not kind of... it's not like being farted in your face, but you can smell Vulcanus kind of chemistry experiment going on. And sulfur dioxide. Yeah. If you ever did chemistry at school, you'll know what I mean. God, blimey. Right, let's see if I can get popped by that. See if I can push that massive, big, pooey smell aside. Not really a pooey smell, it's this is sulfur. There is a difference, you know, it's a difference. If you know, I don't like to say if you know what you're talking about, but if you kind of are a bit more used to the sort of different smells of different beers, ciders and things like that, you will smell the difference between a skunky cider and Burtonisation, it's not cider, beer and Burtonisation. You will smell the difference between sulfites in things. You know, you'll smell when a beer is off, and you get to know different things when a beer smells of this, or if it's gone a bit saison or a bit, you know, a bit rancid. Which is what really eggs me sometimes. You go to a place like the JBBF and they're not looked after by their own folks. No, they're looked after by volunteers. And the volunteers, on a whole, do a great, great job. But one or two stalls, they're kind of like, think they're the cat's whiskers. They're up their own bottoms and that. And, I am a camera member and all that business. And like, you take it back, you say, mate, this has gone off a little bit. Oh no, it's Burtonisation. You go, mate, it ain't Burtonisation. You know, there you go. Right, I'm having real trouble climbing over that. It's not like it's massive, but it's just too pervasive. There's bittersweet apples in the background. There's bitter apples, kind of like the sheep's nosy sort of apples. Those little... slightly bittersweet sort of taste. And I'm not getting massive other things. It's really difficult. So, let's try that out. I think it's going to be dry. Cheers, bottoms up. That's not bad. That's actually quite good. Now, you're walking a kind of tightrope here, because those kind of sulfites do often bring out flavours as well. It's like putting salt in a stew. Ping, suddenly you salt the stew up a little bit. Ping, and anything you add salt to, it seems to flavour it up. And it's the same sort of thing with sulfites. So kind of, you know, you've got a salt there. They're stinking a little bit, but the minute you taste it, you're getting all those flavours presented. And you're talking a very delicate, bittersweet sort of background note. Slightly sugared, but still nice almost a vinegary, but not vinegar, but a kind of a that sort of acetic sort of taste to it. But a nice sharp sort of taste, you know, almost puckering, but certainly an aperitif sort of thing. I think instead of having it as an accompaniment or having it on its own, I found a space for it in between the two. Have it as an aperitif. Have it before the meal. Get the old flavour buds going. In comes the light stuff, the little bit of like smoked salmon and lettuce or something like that. Or the little prawn cocktail or whatever if you're out of the 80s, you know. Like I am, an 80s child, and that, you know, 20 years old. And that, well, that's just my beard. But as it happens, I've got nose hairs that are older, some of you, some, older than some of you's viewers. Mm. Yes, I firmly recommend that. That's after all that kind of bad mouthing. Firmly recommend that as an aperitif. Get one, crack one there open. If you're having a meal, if you're having people around, crack one, especially if you're having something that's porky or something coming up. Crack one them open. Have your little kind of things like when you've got little kind of different meats, you know, that what's the Italian when you have cob? Oh, blimey, my brain's gone. When you have things like little parmesan, not parmesan, hold on, come on, brain's gone, ink. God blimey. What's the pig that bleeding eats whey and stuff like that? And it tastes of it. God, my brain's gone. Anyway, you get different, like, Italian things. You get the little things with different... You get olives, and then you get different meats and things like that. Those different meats would go ideal with this. Just something a little bit light and smoky. Something light and nice. Little bit of that, little bit of this, little bit of olive. And then crack one of these and get one of these down with it. That would go glorious. Because it's bitter enough to just get the taste buds going, almost squirting out. Lovely stuff. Really lovely stuff. Without a doubt. Dun, 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 dun. Try it. Buy it. Love it. That is lovely. See you next time. Be there or be square. Don't be late. See you soon. Cheerio.